The factory method pattern is the design pattern that you might come across when working with heavily object-oriented languages such as Java or C#. Like with most design patterns, factory methods exist to add a simpler abstraction around a more complicated concept. In this video, we're going to cover the problem that factory methods are solving, and we're going to cover how they solve it. A factory is a building where things are made, and if you look at a factory from the outside, it's usually just a generic square on a map. This is the Boeing factory in Washington. If you were to actually go inside this factory, you'd see loads of machinery and loads of people working away. But from the outside, it's just a simple, unassuming building. The Boeing factory is what in software engineer we would call a closed box, or you might hear this called a black box. And it's called that because the inner workings aren't visible to the casual observer. That's us. Nevertheless, it still does its job of manufacturing things. It hides all that complicated stuff away behind these four walls, essentially. And that concept of hiding away loads of detailed manufacturing business inside a closed box, is what's at the heart of the factory method pattern. Like the Boeing factory, a factory method in your code is hiding away how something is made and presenting a much simpler interface to the wider world. And what kinds of things might you make in a factory method? Well, typically instances of objects. You see, if you're familiar with Java or C# or TypeScript, you'll know that object-oriented languages like these have the concept of an interface that can be implemented in multiple ways. So for example, let's say we have an iAnimal interface and then three implementations, cat, dog, and snake. Now, at various points in our code, we might want to create a new instance of one of these classes, and we might have some logic that decides which class to create. So if we have a function here that identifies an animal from some attributes, the logic might say, if it barks, then create a dog. If it eats mice, then if it is longer than 3 feet, it's a snake, otherwise it's a cat, something like that. Well, this kind of which object do we create logic is what we're going to hide away behind the four walls of our factory. To implement the factory pattern, we create a function somewhere, maybe just a static function, and we have a return type on an object of iAnimal. And then we put the logic in here. Now we can call our factory method and we can say, give me an animal with these three attributes. And it executes this logic and returns some kind of class that implements iAnimal. And it's this return type here that turns our factory method into a closed box. Because remember how a real factory from the outside looks really simple and all the complicated stuff is hidden away? Well, that's what this function does too. The signature of this function looks really simple. It just takes some values and it returns a super generic iAnimal interface. And all the complicated selection logic is hidden away inside that. So that's the factory method pattern in object-oriented software design. You can extend on this to do a lot more than just having one factory method. Have a think about how you could abstract away the construction logic of your objects. Maybe you'd have a class with its own dependencies and its own internal state. Maybe your factory logic would even make off a call to another service or something. It's really up to you what you do with these factory methods. The purpose is to abstract away all of your constructor logic into something that makes the rest of your code cleaner and less complicated. So I hope this video has helped give you an overview of this pattern. For explanations of other software design patterns in object-oriented languages and videos on a bunch of other software development topics, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. My name is James Charlesworth, and this is the Train to Code YouTube channel.